What's up, tired mamas? It's Melissa here with the Cradle Coach, and we're talking about sleep regressions specific for your 6-month-old and your 8-month-old sleep regression. So get ready to learn what to do, how to prepare, and what to expect to preserve your child's sleep. The 6 and 8 month sleep regression often occurs during the nap time or causing early morning wakings. You had a great schedule, an amazing feeding schedule, an amazing routine. Your child was sleeping through the night and taking solid naps. And suddenly, almost out of nowhere, you're dealing with this battle at nap time or this early morning waking. One or the other. The reason this occurs is when your child is waking up early in the morning, all of a sudden they need a nap earlier than their normal regular time. Then you need another nap earlier because all of a sudden your child can't go that long of a stretch. And then again and again, and suddenly you're adding in a nap time, you might be reducing some nap times, and their entire schedule is completely thrown off. Sometimes parents put their child to bed earlier when really what you need to do to preserve this entire schedule and not cause all these bad habits is to stick to a set schedule based around the clock. I really enjoy a time frame here where you can start waking up your child at the set time, making sure that if they wake up earlier, you're actually putting in sleep training habits at that point. Then you can follow the clock set around their new nap schedules, which often you might find around 6 and 8 month sleep regressions, their nap transitions occur. So they were taking 3 great naps, but maybe they need 2 naps now. And that often can transition around this time. So creating a new set schedule for them based around their nap schedules, maybe around wake windows appropriate to this age, can be what you need to do in order to fix the habits that are now happening because of this regression. So wake them up at the same time each morning, have a set schedule for nap times, and then have a set schedule again for your bedtime, making sure that anytime they wake up early, they might fight this, they might regress in some of their old habits, they want to go cling to what they know to be true, go back and make sure you introduce your healthy sleep technique here. Sleep train them, and that's okay. Use a technique you're comfortable with, something that you feel that you can give to your child where they respond best to and you feel comfortable doing consistently. Because you know that no matter what you do here, the consistency is going to win. If you stay consistent about your sleep training technique, you're showing them one action and one action only. And that communicates so much more to them than saying a bunch of different things or doing a bunch of different things. So go back to your sleep training technique, follow a really good schedule, maybe transition them out of 3 naps to 2 naps and follow along with what they can do based around their wake window times appropriate to their age. Comment down below and let us know if your child's going through a 6 or 8 month sleep regression. What are you doing to fix it? And what are some of the signs that they are showing that they're going through a regression? Remember, a regression can occur between 2 to 4 weeks. So get through it, be consistent with a routine, and the more consistent you are, the better it will be for your child to get out of those new habits and into the healthy foundations that we want to introduce them to. Go ahead and check out thecradlecoach.com for more sleep tips, or you can go ahead and check out our Instagram at thecradlecoach for more information on ways to help your child's sleep regression. Sweet dreams.